But where are those who share the memory?
Oh, good luck, Alex. Good luck. Okay, all right. Now to continue on to Genshin. So much has happened last time. Oh, that's right. We were waiting to meet up with our newest Aspondo again. Even if you lower it to the lowest volume, we could still have pure Paimon. You know what? I wouldn't be surprised. Hey, I think they made this game just so Paimon can be the loudest out of everyone. Wait until... Okay. Time to time travel again. Hold on 1 second. Okay, cool.
Let's see Dory today and ask her about where the Divine Knowledge Capsule is.
Correct you to the Sunshine Protection Act. As of November 5th, 2022, Congress has 17 legislation days passed to change. Okay, so that's what I saw earlier. Yeah, it didn't expire yet. It's just, we're just waiting for it to expire. Hi, Dory. Good to see you again.
Here, over here. Oh, welcome back, my loyal patrons. What can I do for you this time? You name it. Can knowledge, supplies, or
I
anything else you
new
need.
Contents,
I'll find a way to get it. Where there's a waterfall of Mora, there's
if
a
If I get there,
can
like
you
way,
really
way,
get
way
us anything
behind.
We want? Anything at all? Uh-huh. So it appears that can knowledge alone is no longer sufficient for your opulent appetite? Then please oblige me. Tell me what you have in mind.
I'd like to buy info on the whereabouts of the Divine Knowledge Capsule.
Oh! I knew customers with pockets as deep as yours would undoubtedly crave something more profound than ordinary can knowledge.
Uh-huh.
But you know, that kind of information isn't going to be cheap. After all, I had to work really hard to weasel my way into the auction site. Not to mention that if anyone found out that I was the leaker, I would be in big trouble.
But
how can we be sure your information is accurate? Paimon's curious how you just happen to have this kind of info the moment we need it.
Because to me, anything of value is what I consider to be my supply. Therefore, I must always be aware of what's hot on the market in order to secure more sales. As for the information's authenticity, well, you've no need to worry about that. I used a camera to take a picture of the transaction. That way, no one can dispute it.
Never question a merchant. I feel like Dory's especially a merchant. Name your price.
It's always a pleasure doing business with such sterling patrons. Now that you've paid in full, here's the scoop. The Divine Knowledge Capsule was purchased yesterday by a certain Misery, the leader of Ayn el Ahmar.
Ayn el Ahmar? You mean the Aramites who worshipped King Geshrit?
Ah, so you're already familiar with them. The group has done everything in their power to obtain the Divine Knowledge Capsule. After all, they believe it contains the power of King Deshret. That Divine Knowledge Capsule is unlike any other canned knowledge I've seen before. It was glowing bright red. The capsule is clearly visible in the picture I took. You can look for yourself.
Thanks for the info, Dory.
Thank
Please,
you,
it's my pleasure. It's all thanks to discerning customers such as yourselves that my efforts yesterday were not in vain. Please, don't hesitate to contact me if you ever need anything else in the future.
If the math's correct.
Mora for Dory opens doors.
Okay.
Well, We figured out where the Divine Knowledge Capsule is. It turns out it ended up in the hands of Ayn el-Ahmar.
True history is
Let's head back and talk to Al-Haytham.
Al-Haytham. Gotta remember that name. His name is so hard to memorize right now. I don't want to take this elevator. Gosh darn it. Husbando. Not yet. Gotta meet up with him first. Okay, Husbando versus Husbando. Hi.
Al-Haytham! We got the info you wanted!
Really? Alright. Let's hear it.
They're very good. We're about to face.
Dory even gave us evidence to verify the intel. Have a look.
Huh, look at that. Clear as day. It must have taken some guts just to infiltrate the scene of the Aramite's transaction. But then, to get close enough to take a picture like this. Bold move, Dory. Very bold move. Alright. The person in this picture is indeed Misery, the leader of Ayn el-Ahmar. And the glowing red capsule he's holding appears to be the Divine Knowledge Capsule. In which case, if we play our cards right, when we confront them next week, we should be able to force them to show their hand.
At first, Paimon didn't get why you were provoking these Ayn el-Ahmar guys. But now, it sort of makes sense. Everything's playing right into your hands. After we defeat them, we can finally have a serious talk with their boss and get them to lend us the Divine Knowledge Capsule.
Thank you for your time and efforts. Take a few days off while I make some preparations. Let's meet up again on the afternoon of the arranged date, 3 o'clock sharp.
Oh, God.
See you then.
Oh, we don't have to time travel. Woo!
Al-Haytham sure is taking his time. Where could he be? Oh, there he is.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Let's head to the pier in front of Faros Lighthouse.
I'm imagining I'll have a party with him and Zhongli, and then Chowd. Who else do I have?
Nope. Where's the same?
Okay. Hold up. Party brainstorm. Okay, let's see. Domain team, boss team. Okay, Zhongli's gonna be in this party, right? And then...
Come on, don't keep me waiting.
Chowd's gonna be in this party, and then who else is gonna be in this party?
I am the man!
Oh, God. Okay, why don't you get the new Husbando in here? Woo! And then compete with the cheery party? Jimmy party, Husbando party! Holy heck! It's gonna be great. Okay. Oh, man. Okay, wait. Oh my gosh, I haven't been that far. And Fischl. Well, Fischl's there as a placeholder, okay? What? Oh, are you serious? I have to wait for the lift to come back. Can I? Ah, there's no teleport. Waypoint near there. Okay. Hi. Alright. Oh, there's Oz with Fischl. Oz doesn't count. He's not a tall Husbando. Only tall Husbandos are allowed. Oh, whoops. The Zhongli is top Husbando, so no one can be. Am I going in the right direction? I feel like I'm. Oh, yeah, I'm going in the right direction. Oh. I think we blasted the music up because it's really cozy. Just playing this game and exploring this area. Okay. Imagine Oz is the tallest Bondo. He has to be a really good husband, though. If we were to get my vote.
Oh, hey, Thumb. I knew you were crazy, but I didn't know you were crazy enough to actually show up.
Oh, they're out of here? Oh my gosh.
It was I who demanded that these negotiations take place. I was more worried that you might go back on your promise. But to your credit, it appears that you're sticking to your word. This is turning into quite an occasion. I also brought some backup. I assume you don't mind.
Oh yeah, have you brought us before?
Aren't you the brat from the restaurant the other day? You've come to support this lunatic because he helped you out? Fine. Your funeral.
You spoke too soon. It's your funeral.
I'm not going to mince my words. Once we're done with you, you'll be nothing more than fish food. Get 'em, boys!
Oh, do I have a good party comp?
Here they come! Good luck, you two!
Rid of you, Paimon.
Oh, that's close enough!
Solidify!
Ha! Born of ice and frost! This is long overdue!
Okay. Cool, nice.
Go as planned! Ha!
Ta! Ha! Where do you think you're?
Jumpy, jumpy, go!
Oh, yep!
Boom!
Oh, that was awesome. Oh, hi.
Hi-ya! Boom! Ha! 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 Ha!
No touching!
Following orders.
Stabilize!
I swear by my sword!
Blazing delight!
Boing, boing, boom!
My boss has to
die!
Order guide.
Okay. I was gonna save this for the boss, but that's fine.
For Rex Lapis!
Go as planned!
Academia scum! Boss! Finally! Did you use it? Great! Now we can... Boss?
Oh, the zombie?
Boss!
Boss!
What's wrong?
What happened to him?
We have to cut his Akasha connection. Now.
Here's the moment you fell in love.
Target fire! Arrest him!
I fell in love way earlier before this, but man, that fight scene was smooth and tough.
Do not impede our work. Is that understood, Alhatham?
Of course. I was only trying to help.
Take him away!
Oh, okay, he's arresting. That's good.
World. Forget me.
Also, this cutscene is really beautiful. I just realized how smooth it is.
What in Tibet just happened? It's like that big guy suddenly lost his mind.
It looks like he used the Divine Knowledge Capsule.
You mean the Divine Knowledge Capsule did that to him?
Oh, it is so good. It is so good. Speaking of which, Acacia did mention.
Oh, yeah. You mean how some researchers go insane after getting knowledge from Erminsul?
I've heard of numerous incidents of researchers in Satyavada life going insane. The state that man is now in suggests that this is a similar situation. This divine knowledge capsule does appear to be linked to the gods, but beyond that, it doesn't seem anything like the rumors suggest. Possessing it doesn't grant you divine wisdom or power. Did you hear what he said? World, forget me. What could that possibly mean?
Familiar words. Where have we heard them before? That's exactly what I heard before. And we're so, oh, game, thank you for answering my question.
Then that means the academia got the divine knowledge capsule back too. Oh, what a shame. We were so close. Still,
the Sumeru music
Paimon didn't expect the divine knowledge capsule would be so dangerous. Imagine if we tried to open it.
I mean, I knew
who
had
knows what would have happened to us.
As things stand, there is no reason for me to remain in Port Ormos. I believe our collaboration has also reached its end.
Oh, no.
We were so busy trying to find the divine knowledge capsule that Paimon forgot to ask you something. Since you're a member of the academia, do you have any idea how we can go about meeting Lesser Lord Kusanali?
Truthfully, I don't. Lesser Lord Kusanali appears to exist outside of Sumeru's entire administration. Most of the time, you wouldn't know she exists at all. Moreover, since the Academia possesses the Akasha, a symbol of our deity's wisdom, scholars have no reason to desire to make contact with the deity herself anyway.
Everything about Lesser Lord Kusanali is such a mystery!
I'm heading back to the Academia. How about you two?
It's almost the day of the Sub-Zeros Festival! Maybe we should head back.
We've been rushed off our feet over the past few days, so maybe a little rest and relaxation will do us good.
Then we'll part ways here, Alhatham. Until we meet again.
Thank you for speaking for us, Paimon. Stay amazing, emergency food.
Now, do I deal with this thing first? Or should I produce the report that the higher-ups require?
What are you up to, Husbando? Rest is good for the weary. Very true. We finished a chapter! Or Act 1. I don't know. Becoming a Sub-Zero's Festival. Alright. Time for us to... Okay, what's the wish banner? Is this the Nahida? Okay. Time for us to travel back to Sumeru and boy. Look at this whole area and still need to unlock. I'm assuming this is the desert area. Okay. But for now, let's stay in the forest. Alex, if you know, don't tell me. I want to figure out for myself. Oh. God dang it. Lovely place. The desert is never a lovely place. Unless you don't mind extreme heat. Okay. So we're back in the big city. The festival is finally coming up.
We didn't miss the Sub-Zero's festival, right? Let's hurry and find Dunyarzad.
Okay, the wildlife and the
must be around the Grand Bazaar, since she showed us around there last time.
I would not want desert as my first choice. Okay. Some more exciting.
There she
not
is.
Exciting.
Dinyarzad, we're back.
Lively music, hopefully.
Just as promised. Traveler and Paimon. I'm so glad that you two came back to celebrate Lesser Lord Kusanali's birthday.
Looks like we made it back in time.
Indeed. The festival's tomorrow. We've been preparing for so long that I can't help but feel a little nervous.
There's no need to be nervous. Paimon's sure that Lesser Lord Kusanali will feel everyone's gratitude.
Wait a second.
Thanks, Paimon. I hope that everyone who comes to the festival will also have a good time. Speaking of which, did you manage to make your way to Port Ormos? Discover anything over there?
Of course we went! A lot of things happened.
Oh, is that Lux Pale? I changed it so that it's more like the green of Sumeru, but I don't think that translated well. Unfortunately, we didn't find any new information on Lesser Lord Kusanali. Instead, we were left with more questions.
I see. Sounds like you two had another exciting adventure.
Yeah, that's true.
There is another chance.
There's like a couple of other people
I would love to join.
Not calling out
lady,
any names,
if you
of
went
course,
to Port Ormos in your current state, we'd both be in for a lifetime of trouble.
Hey.
Yeah, you were eavesdropping.
Cool.
It's called covert protection. Keeping an ear out for what's
cool
going
lady.
On around my employer is part of the job.
It's all right, Dia. I merely said I would like to go. I know better than to think my body could handle it. The festival's tomorrow. I've been doing nothing but causing trouble for you. So, Dia, please take some time to relax.
The festival's tomorrow?
I'll be fine.
We have to wait.
Even when you put it that way, it still doesn't feel right.
Oh, yeah, I was gonna call a cool cat
lady,
but
don't worry, my guardian knight.
Couldn't remember.
Okay, fine, but only tonight. Tomorrow's a big day, and many no-good scumbags are gonna try to take advantage of that.
Paimon, good job.
Oh, you two must be exhausted from your long journey back to the city. My apologies for not realizing this sooner.
Big yawn.
I've already prepared a room for you to rest. Please follow me.
Oh, we have a room?
You're so thoughtful.
Oh, you're so kind.
I'm so ready.
Let's go. Chapter 3, Act 2, The Morn a Thousand Roses Bring. Oh. Okay. Zach! Good to see you. How are you? Monday's fine. Middle of the week. Paimon is always ready for hospitality. Oh, Paimon's ready for like anything involving food. You know, we all
here
know
we
that.
Are. It's also fairly close to where I've been staying.
Oh, is this our
room? It looks really nice.
Also, Zach, how has been your birthday celebration been going? How is being a year older? Well, not to remind you that you're getting older. I mean, Alex just reminded himself and me that we're both getting old. So, sorry for the trouble, Dan.
Not at all. Just tell me more about your adventures when you next get the chance.
That's Paimon's specialty! Paimon can tell you stories next time!
Oh yeah, no. Okay, yeah. Yeah, no worries. I feel like Halloween was not too long ago. I saw you've been playing. Yes, you said you were playing Life is Strange 2. Were you also playing another game? I don't remember. Oh! You know what? You live in a certain state, or you live in a certain type of state. I will not talk about it any further. I guess that could be said for our whole country in general.
Oh, if you don't mind, how about we all walk around together tomorrow?
Oh, okay.
all of my friends will be working the festival, and Dia's still insisting on her covert protection.
Then we'll cozy up, celebrate this festival.
It'll be pretty hard to relax and enjoy the festival if Dia's constantly hovering over you, right?
I'll keep you company tomorrow.
Then let's meet at the nearby bazaar first thing tomorrow morning. Have a great night.
It's a deal! Good night, Junior-san!
I may be too excited to fall asleep tonight. See you tomorrow.
Paimon started to really look forward to the Sub-Zero Festival, too! Will there be lots of yummy food? Oh, no,
of course, you gotta ask
about
the food, Paimon.
Is just gonna keep Paimon up all night. The earlier we sleep, the better. Let's go inside, Traveler.
Smart, Paimon. Very smart. Stop thinking about the food too much. Just focus on getting the rest of you.
Did we oversleep?
I would love to have
we
that.
We should go meet Dunyarzad right away!
I can oversleep and not worry about having to wake up early. The coming of the Sub-Zero Festival. Alright. Let's go. Definitely looking forward to getting the first God of War PC. Actually, remember the old God of War games, which were quite brutal. The newer one is more story driven. Yeah, that's why I got. It is very story driven for sure. I don't know if it like stands out compared to some of the other games I played on my PlayStation, but so far I've been like enjoying it.
Traveler, Paimon, I've been waiting for you two.
Good morning, Dunyarzad. We must have overslept a little bit.
Not at all. I arrived early. Today
I have been
is finally
the
here. I must cherish every moment as if it were gold.
You've worked so hard for this day. You gotta enjoy it to the fullest.
Yep.
You know it. It's just that, as expected, I had some trouble falling asleep last night. I'm hoping my body won't be too much of an issue today. Well, shall we?
Feels.
Let's start with the stalls over there.
Feels.
Many vendors came out of the blue to support the event, and they insisted on covering costs themselves.
Oh, I had to follow.
Let's go
you.
Give them some business.
They paid for everything out of pocket? Sounds like they're not in this just for the mora.
They all said that contributing to a lively festival atmosphere is more important than money. Especially since we don't often get to celebrate Lesser Lord Kusanali's birthday.
Ooh, yeah, they're selling food over that way! Let's go take a look!
I enjoyed them. Apparently there are some people who... I know there are people who don't play games for story, and that's totally fine, but... There's like this one person in Jesse Cox's stream that was a lot of games these days are too many cinematics and they're all story driven. I don't like that. They need to go back to the way they were, and I'm like, calm down, first of all. Jesse Cox seems to disagree with you, and two, you don't need to push down your opinion on everyone. Okay, if you don't like story-driven games, that's fine. Just leave it at that. Oh, yes, the food is here. There's like watermelon. Oh, okay. Cutscene.
This is a stall offering foods from the Haft Mewa feast.
Oh, you could tell straight away. I thought most people nowadays wouldn't know.
Mushrooms, flowers, and all kind of fruit?
Fortnite?
It's all vegetarian stuff. Paimon's a little disappointed.
Paimon,
what's the
you're not a vegetarian?
Come
on,
you mentioned just
delicious.
Now.
It's another Sub-Zero's festival tradition. People used to set their tables with 7 different foods. Generally speaking, the most common selections were foods like Rukishaba mushrooms, Milopala lotuses, Sumeru roses, Sunsetias, Kapalatas, Hara fruits, and Zaytun peaches.
So, the Sub-Zero Festival is a vegetarian holiday?
You don't have to be a vegetarian to enjoy the spread. We just used the seven foods to symbolize the seven virtues of the Dendro Archon.
That's really
Wait,
neat.
But if that's the case, if Sumeru uses vegetarian food to represent the Dendro Archon, then wouldn't the Pyro Archon's festival be full of food like...
Oh my gosh, Paima, your
brain
went there.
Grilled steak?
Are you serious?
Oh, Traveler, we have to go to Natlon as soon as possible.
Name drop.
I hope your wish comes true one day, Paimon.
Thanks. All right, how about we also check out some of these other stuff?
People argue all the time on what makes a good story good, but even a good... Yeah, it's really subjective. Like,
Dear customers, would you like to try your hand at alchemical divination?
Like
What's alchemical divination?
Really
those two things sound like they'd be fun to try together.
Deep
right?
Like,
I thought the same when I first heard about it. It is said to be a mysterious craft invented by none other than Lesser Lord Kusanali herself.
So, how does it work?
It's quite simple. After you give me any two alchemical reagents, I'll use them to perform a random transmutation.
Sure sounds random.
Always a fun part
so
of this
random
game.
That it will probably fail.
That is precisely what we need. After the transmutation fails, your one and only diviner here will interpret the remnants.
Two RNG.
Well, according to Lesser Lord Kusanali, everything is interconnected, and all that occurs can be traced back to fate. You could say this is a pearl of old wisdom.
Why does everything sound so much more credible when Dunyarzad says it? Are you guys working together?
But you
so
know what?
That's the true wisdom behind it. This young lady sure knows her stuff. So, how about it? So. Want to give it a try?
And of course, everything's interconnected in environmental science, so that's fair. All right, I guess I could give it a go. Oh, I had to select stuff. Hold on. Beep, 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 beep. Right, okay. What to give away? Oh, I have so much iron. I don't need iron. I'm fine. Okay. What else don't I need? Noctilus Jade. I feel like I've been getting a lot of Noctilus Jade lately, too. Alright, here you go. Two agents. You know, switch back.
Okay, one moment. It's the moon.
Paimon wants to take a look too. Is it? It looks more like a pie that Paimon bit into.
Of course, Paimon. Of course.
Generally speaking, the moon signifies.
Who needs tea leaves or divination when you could just give pies?
Wait a moment.
Is he really looking it up in a book?
Oh, I remember now. It means illusions and lies.
Illusions and lies? That sounds rather ominous.
Is that scripted?
Yes, but this book says that if you trust your intuition and overcome your fears, the sun will surely rise.
I feel like that would be a lot of work.
He's not even trying to hide his book anymore.
Naturally, fate will only ever show you the beginning of a journey. It is up to you to forge your own ending. Oh, thank you so much. I'll keep that in mind.
Oh, it's nothing. I'm just learning as I go.
Lies.
Guess that was
very
still
honest.
Pretty interesting. Okay,
very
on
honest.
To the next stall.
Okay.
They say the Sub-Zero's festival was very lively a long, long time ago. Large flower carriages used to parade through the city. As they headed towards Port Ormos, people would throw flowers, candy, and liquor all along the way.
Dunyarzad's eyes are sparkling right now.
Oh, I wish I could have seen that spectacle. But if you ask me, I'm sure Nilu's Dance of Sub-Zeros would be just as impressive.
Attention! Soldiers, fall into formation if you want any Yalda candies.
That mustache. What? That whole
it's
outfit.
It's a weird guy with a weird hat.
Weird guy with a weird hat. Good description, Paimon.
Hey,
oh, it's gonna say the same
on.
Thing.
Wow!
You took the words right out of my mouth.
Miss Dunyarzad, the children love you even more than the Yalda candies. In the few short days it took to prepare for the Sub-Zero's festival, the children have all grown very fond of you.
The Hallowed Night of Flowers. It's an honor that you know my name.
It's the Night of Flowers.
Attention! In the name of Ferris, the Knight of Flowers, I commend you on your contributions to the glorious Sub-Zero's festival. All right, little soldiers. Take your Yalda candies and don't forget your loyalty to Lesser Lord Kusanali. Dismissed!
And that's right.
Yes, Knight Ferris!
What is going on here?
Ferris, the Knight of Flowers, is another Sub-Zero's festival icon and one immensely popular with children.
Oh, that guy is posing as a mascot?
In the past, the actor portraying Ferris would also sit on a flower carriage.
Oh,
it's all thanks to Miss Dunyarzad's sponsorship that the children can make such wonderful memories today.
As are we to you, Vihar.
Actually a weird person.
Oh, not at all. Oh, speaking of tradition, do you want some Yalda candies? They're a festival staple, and I happen to have some boxes ready here. Take a look and pick whichever one you want.
Which box we can
Whichever one? Don't these boxes all look the same?
That is the fun part. Each box contains a random flavor. It's up to the luck of the draw. Flavors include lavender melon, hara fruit, sunsetia.
Ooh, those all sound pretty good.
And there's also lizard tail and oni kabuto.
Huh? What's up with those two flavors?
Oh, no.
Oni kabuto is a little spicier than lizard tail.
Dunyarzad, you tried them before?
Does he have a mouth?
Traveler, help Paimon pick one. Paimon wants the sunsetia flavor.
I saw his mouth move, but... Oh, Dad, I'll be able to get the exact flavor you want. Don't blame me if I choose the wrong one.
It's all right. Paimon believes in you.
Thanks for your belief, Paimon.
I also believe in your intuition.
I'll destroy it immediately.
Great. These boxes of candy are numbered 1 to 5 from left to right.
Oh,
which
right,
one do you
you're
want?
Right. He doesn't have a mouth. From left to right. I picked 2 because it's blue. Wait, let me give it another thought. No, never mind. Left to right? My left or your left? What a scammer. He meant to say his left. Let's see, number 4. What? No. I'm so confused. How did they name this? Number 1? Okay, I'm gonna pick this one because it's blue.
Attention! That's unfortunately Lizard Tail.
Oh, Paimon thought you survived so many epic battles because you had incredible luck. But looks like Paimon was wrong.
I'm gonna destroy your belief in me immediately.
The Sunsetia flavored candy was in box number 4. How about this? The most important thing is that everyone has a good time at the festival. So please, take both boxes.
Oh,
really?
Nice bonus.
Thanks a lot, Knight of Candies.
It's Knight of Flowers, not Knight of Candies.
Knight of Candies suits you better. Let's be honest here.
Paimon really wilted the carriageless Knight of Flowers.
They all basically sound the same. We got our candy, so let's keep going.
Of course. Paimon's priorities.
Actually, I just remembered that I left something behind. Since you're here, can you come with me to get it?
Sure thing.
Dunyarzad, you probably forgot because you're so excited about the Sub-Zero's festival.
How embarrassing.
Okay, good to head back. To head? Oh, not headquarters. Nearby quarters. Our hotel room? Back to our hotel room. Let's go. Ooh, I like the cozy courtyard tour. Very cozy. Sumeru, very cozy.
We're too late. Who knew the little lady was such an early riser?
Oh,
I know,
what are
right?
these guys up to now?
Hey, wait a minute. Toss, isn't that her?
Oh, are you guys ambushing me?
Oh, that most certainly is. We're in luck. She's walking right into our clutches.
What
now? Those Aramites don't look like they're up to any good.
Who are you? I don't believe the Homayanis hired you.
That's right. We haven't received any of their mora, but I wonder how much the Homayanis would shell out to get you back.
They're kidnappers! Traveler, hurry and protect Dunyarzad!
Professional here, ready to go. Yeah, we are gonna stop this right now. No kidnapping allowed on
our
watch.
Did you scumbags even consider that the Homayanis might have hired a merc that outclasses you?
Oh.
You're Dia!
Good job.
Dia the Flame Mane! No wonder we mercs haven't heard anything about you for so long. You sold your unruly mane to the highest bidder.
Don't speak so disrespectfully. My family started working with her as gratitude for her past kindness to us.
Don't worry about it, my lady. Just some friendly banter between mercs. One punch and those rabid dogs will expose themselves for what they really are.
Aren't your claws all dull by now? Don't get too cocky!
Yeah, been speaking a lot. Oh, wow, where did you all come from? Oh, don't worry, we got you.
Traveler,
we'll
take Miss Dunyarzad to a safe location.
No, we're gonna stay and help! There's too many of them!
Daya's top priority is our player safety.
You're right. All right, fine!
Paimon wasn't on the action,
be careful,
even though
Dia.
She never fights.
Don't waste your time worrying about me. This is my job. Look out for yourself. After I've wiped the floor with them, I'll go find you all.
All right, let's go. Let's go. Are you fighting? Oh, what? Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, we ain't fighting. We had to escape. Sad. We don't get to fight this day yet. Oh, no. You okay?
Dunyarzad, are you okay? You look a little pale. Are you in shock?
I'm fine. My body always reacts like this whenever I exert myself too much.
Could have walked as though
you sure you're okay?
I feel like there was more to that.
I'll be fine after some rest. I'm more worried about Dia.
If that was like,
after all, none of this would have happened
like
if I hadn't insisted on coming out today.
That was pretty short. Maybe it's because I've been too conditioned to with stealth missions and whatnot from Assassin's Creed. She's protecting you because she's a griever.
Yeah! Don't worry!
Oh, what is this cutscene?
My lady, Traveler, found ya.
Yay!
Dia!
Nice.
You took care of them so fast!
Nice.
Any more of them? Or rather, did anyone follow you?
Nah.
Dia, your arm!
Oh, this? I'm fine. It's just a scratch. Normally, they wouldn't have been able to land a hit on me at all, but I'm still getting used to this new greatsword.
Please, let me take a closer look.
Come on, it's nothing. Us mercs aren't as fragile as you think.
Hold on, you said something about a new greatsword.
But I'm also excited for the
What
Japan
happened to the one
you were
using
About that, well, I sold it because I was low on Mora. Stuff like this happens every now and then.
Oh, something's going on.
It can't be. The anonymous donation that was used for the venue's final round of preparations?
Are you okay?
Hey, Miss Dunyarzad, I wasn't trying to make you cry, and I'm not gonna lose my commission because I made my employer cry, am I?
Okay, making your employer cry won't affect your commission, but selling your weapon without permission and getting hurt? I'll have to reevaluate your performance.
You're so unreasonable, my lady.
Thank you very much, Dia.
Tis better scratch.
Don't be like that. I get embarrassed really easily.
You can pass this bridge easily. Aw, she gets embarrassed. Aw, that's cute. Oh, God.
Are you feeling unwell again, Junior-Zod?
Looks like she's
my lady,
not really doing
your condition. Traveler, can you take her somewhere to rest? I'll look around the area to make sure we're safe from an ambush.
Leave it to me.
Truly. I'm sorry for the trouble, everyone.
You're fine. That's what we're here for. We're the Traveler. Okay. Let's fly. Yeah, performance evaluation is always fun.
Are you feeling better, Junior-Zod?
Yes, much better. Just give me a few moments and I'll be good to go.
There's a burst expression just now where she mentions your condition. Just how serious is your illness?
I didn't realize you were concerned about it. I guess I shouldn't continue to keep it a secret.
What's going on?
I was actually born with LSR. It's terminal.
No. We're just seeing the tree-like skin now.
Can't believe it's LSR!
Oh, you've already heard of LSR. In that case, you probably know about its severity. Sumeru's current medical advancements still haven't been able to find a cure. The disease's progression can only be delayed through environmental therapy.
Junior-Zod.
There's no need to be sad. I've always lived with LSR and I came to terms with it a long time ago. Compared to the simple fact that I'm afflicted with this, its effects on my life have been much more painful. I know that my family loves me dearly. They've done all they can to provide the best environment for me so that I can live for that much longer. However, I know I will one day succumb to this. Did you know? Before I ran away from home this time, the world outside of my home didn't even know that I existed. Since I was a child, all I could do was sit on my bed and stare at everything outside of my window. I'm sure my family's worried and disappointed in me for running away, but I just didn't want to have any regrets. I wanted to meet other people. To me, there's nothing more beautiful than being able to meet and speak with others. Not to mention the incredible time spent preparing for the festival, the joy on everyone's faces here, and all the support I've received from friends like Dia. This way, when my final day does arrive, he'll be less sorrowful. At the very least, many people will remember that I once existed in this world, right?
Don't say that. You still have happy times yet to come.
As long as you don't forget Paimon, Paimon also won't forget about you. No.
Aww,
even if
Paimon.
You forget Paimon, Paimon will
forget
still remember
emergency
you.
Food.
Thank you two so much. I apologize for the depressing conversation. This is out of character for me. To be honest, Lesser Lord Kusanali gave me the courage to do all of this. If it weren't for her encouragement, I wouldn't have taken that first step.
You're the one who has been resolute in the face of your illness. You're already so strong for never giving up.
Thanks. There will always be frustrations in life, but I know that the point of living is not to leave behind any regrets.
That's a mindset I need to work on, too. Being able to
live on
without regretting.
Isn't it almost time?
Is it time for the festival?
Almost time for what?
Paimon, you book guy?
Isn't the dance of Sub-Zeros about to begin? It's the part of the festival that I've been looking forward to the most.
Oh, that's right.
Nilu will recreate that legendary scene with her most splendid dancing. And the Sub-Zeros festival will conclude amid everyone's applause and blessings. And with that, my wish will also...
Oh?
Then what are we waiting for? Let's go to the stage!
Let's go.
Yeah, we should still make it in time.
Let's go. We can't miss Nilu's amazing dance in her outfit, even though I keep forgetting your name. Sorry. Sorry, Nilu. Hope you can forgive me. Treasure Street. Interesting game. Here we go. Let's go down here. Where's the stage? I forgot where the stage was. Oh, never mind. Cutscene.
Were you not aware that the law prohibits this type of performance from taking place without prior permission?
Oh, what's going on?
Over there! Someone's yelling at Nilu!
I think I just saw the Academia's Grand Sage. Why is he here in person?
But the Dance of Sub-Zeros is one of the key parts of the Sub-Zeros Festival. If we can't perform it...
The Sub-Zeros Festival. The law also prohibits the private hosting of large-scale religious festivals. Only the Academia can host such an event. If you continue to resist, we will have to order an investigation into every single event organizer. The Grand Sage has already granted you much leniency. I advise that you exercise tact.
How did things turn out like this?
The Academia was originally responsible for the Sub-Zeros Festival, but they failed this responsibility for many years. I need to speak with them.
Don't go. They had fantasy in all of this. If we forced our hand too much, this situation may get ugly.
This is a hard pill to swallow, but... You're right. Things would only get worse.
Art. Dance. Aren't you ashamed of pursuing such frivolous and meaningless activities in this land of knowledge and reason?
He definitely sounds like...
Our Archon created the utopia that is Sumeru City for all scholars who sought validity, verity, and truth, while people like you wish to defile it.
No! I believe that our Archon never rejected the arts. Even the Goddess of Flowers dedicated a dance to her.
With your lack of intellectual credentials, I do not believe you are qualified to debate with me.
Rude.
What you should be doing is finding workers to tear down this ridiculous eyesore. When we return, have the scribe draft an ordinance before the next Nyagarbaha day that prohibits public art performances. We will announce it to the public later via the Akasha.
Understood. I will inform him when I return.
This guy is very suspicious.
The Sub-Zeros Festival. Go celebrate the birth of that god to your heart's content.
Nilu, are you okay?
Oh, Dunyarzad. You all saw that just now? The Grand Sage ordered us to stop the performance.
Yeah.
Let's go somewhere the Academia can't find us and perform there. But how do we let everyone know? And what about the atmosphere on the stage? Or we could get people to block them off so they can't interrupt the performance. No. They just threatened to investigate the organizers. If we were caught...
Nilu, it's all right. Don't worry about it.
But you've been looking forward to the Dance of Sub-Zeros so much, and I know how important this festival is to you. I don't want you to have any regrets.
It's okay. Seeing you care this much about my feelings is more than enough. It would be too risky to continue the Sub-Zeros festival at this point. I don't want to get everyone in trouble.
If you say so.
Looks like we had to investigate what's going on at the Academia.
You can sneak out for the next Sub-Zeros Festival, right? We'll make sure the next one is a smashing success.
The next one. Yes. Okay. It's a promise. It will be a smashing success.
Oh, she had bandages on.
I can't believe this is how things turned out. Those heartless geezers.
Is there anything else we can do?
It really is okay. There's nothing we can do about it.
Investigate the Academia.
Still, I'd be lying if I said I had no regrets. I would have loved to see Nilu's dance.
Sorry. That was blocking the...
A lot happened today. It's a shame the festival ended the way it did. Nilo and Dunyarzad promised to make the next Sub-Zero's festival a success, but Dunyarzad is running out of time.
I'm sure she knows that very well.
Yeah.
Huh? What's going on? What? What is this?
All connections have been secured to construct the most stable framework possible.
What?
The project has entered its most critical phase. Power has begun to flow from...
What is going on? Why does it sound like a robotic transmission just now?
Yeah.
Wow, why is God in me, Paimon?
Right,
you're the one who sleeps a lot more. Rude. Okay. Okay. Let's go talk to Dawn. Because I don't think she can ever recover from that disappointment.
Good morning, Dunyarzad. Sorry we're late.
Not at all. I arrived early.
You seem kind of tired. Did you not get enough sleep?
That's a good
I'm doing
question,
well.
Paimon.
There's no need to worry. Shall we go? Let's start with the stalls over there.
Sure! Traveler? Why are you just standing there? Let's get going!
Because something weird happened and we're trying to figure out what happened. Oh, we're doing this again? Oh, God. And now she's walking slower because she's depressed.
Ooh, they're selling food over that way! Let's go take a look!
Oh, no. This is not good. Oh, God.
This is all fresh foods from the Hoftmewa feast.
You are quite well informed, miss. I thought most people nowadays wouldn't know.
They're all plants! Oh, Paimon's a little disappointed.
So...
Actually, what is the Hoftmewa feast you mentioned just now?
Wait.
It's one of the Sub-Zero's festival's traditions. People used to set their tables with seven different foods to symbolize the seven virtues of the Dendro Archon.
Wait, sorry, it's just from just now. Something feels really familiar! Okay, something was off! It's like, wait a minute, why are we doing this again? And at first I thought it was just like a daily thing Dunn has to do, but it turns out, soon as she started talking, oh heck.
Remnants appear to be in the form of the moon.
Why are we
really?
Going
Paimon
back in
thought
time?
It looked like some
Why
kind
are
of
we
food?
In a time loop? I was not expecting this game to have time loops.
The moon signifies... It's escaping me for now.
Oh, heck.
Wait a moment.
Is he really looking it up in a book?
Oh, right. It means illusions and lies.
We are seeing a whole bunch of illusions.
But if you trust your intuition
anyway.
And overcome your fears, the sun will surely rise.
Is this deja vu?
Understood. I'll keep that in mind.
This is very deja vu. What is this?
Oh, it's nothing.
Why is she
I'm
acting
just learning
like
as I
we
go.
Haven't done this yesterday?
Guess that was still pretty interesting. Okay, on to the next stall.
Did something happen?
So, where to next?
Something happened while we were in that weird cutscene? Going on. I'm so lost. But she's still walking slow. Is she walking slower than before? I can't even tell anymore. I'm so confused. I'm so lost. Oh, there's the weird night of flowers. Is he gonna do the same thing too?
Yes!
All right, soldiers. Now that you have your Yalda candies, don't forget your loyalty to Lesser Lord Kusanagi. Dismissed!
Yes, Knight Ferris!
Are you sure, Alex? You said you watched playthroughs of
this. Is this a play?
Don't lie to me.
Ferris, the Knight of Flowers, is another Sub-Zero's Festival icon and one immensely popular with children.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
It's all thanks to Miss Dunyarzad's sponsorship that the children can meet the Knight of Flowers.
Oh,
do you want some Yalda candies? I happen to have some boxes ready here. Take a look and pick whichever one you want.
Oh, gosh. Is the whole city underneath some kind of curse that curses everything?
It's not that simple. Each box contains a random flavor. It's up to the luck of the draw. Flavors include lavender melon, hara fruit, sunsetia.
Okay, do we get to pick something different
how
this
interesting.
Time? That's a better question.
And there's also lizard tail and oni kabuto.
Ugh, why do those flavors even exist? Traveler, help Paimon pick one. Paimon wants to eat the sunsetia flavor.
Oh, so that's why
Great.
We're going for sunsetia.
These boxes of candy are numbered 1 to 5 from left to right.
Okay.
Which one do you want?
I'll pick number 4. Was it number 4? I think it was number 4.
Ah, excellently chosen. Number 4 is
hey,
indeed
time travel
sunsetia.
Does help. We didn't pick the blue one this time.
Ha ha! Paimon bet you had incredible luck, and Paimon was right!
I don't think that was luck. No, we definitely remember what was going on. Something is going on. I don't know why, but I knew it must have been number 4. Wait, okay. Either we time traveled, or we're still in the present time, but our mind time traveled somehow. I don't know. This is a confusing concept.
How's that possible? It's obviously random.
Why do I keep having this sense of deja vu? What a strange feeling.
Maybe we didn't sleep very well last night. Or maybe we slept too much.
I mean, that could be it. I'm sorry, Dungeon. I have to leave for a moment.
Oh,
sure.
Something
weird's going on.
Huh? Where are you going? You're just gonna walk off like that?
No, you're ridiculous. Tender, it's just a payout. That's definitely why we're overthinking. Because it's late at night. Okay, time to go get a drink so we can wash away all our worries. But yeah, something is going on for sure. For sure. Oh yeah, that's right, Pete. Well, thank you for
a feeling of deja vu.
Still being here, though.
Oh, Paimon knows what that is. It's when you feel like you've already experienced whatever is going on. In that case, Paimon also felt something like that today.
Wait.
But that's just our brains playing tricks on us. Isn't
but why were you acting like?
So why'd you run here in such a hurry?
Just now? I want to see if I could get rid of this deja vu.
So that's it. You're intentionally doing things you usually wouldn't, and seeing if you still get that same feeling of deja vu.
It's a weird time thing.
Welcome, you two. Are you here for lunch? What would you like to eat?
One charcoal big. That cake, please.
Got it. You don't look like you're from these parts, but I gotta say, you've got good taste.
Wait a minute.
I'll give this order
this
to the kitchen.
What's going on?
Charcoal-baked Agilina cake? Isn't it that burnt thing that didn't look tasty at all? Oh, Paimon understands what you're trying to do now. You'd never normally order something like this. really gonna eat it? Isn't this going a bit too far?
We have to do what we have to do, Paimon. Get ready. I don't know what's gonna happen. Oh, our faces.
How was it? The look on your face is telling Paimon that it tasted awful.
It actually tasted really good. What? What's going on?
Then, you mean...
this flavor. I've definitely eaten this before.
That's impossible. We were just talking about how gross it looked. So, would this be a case of taste bud deja vu?
Why are we getting deja vu in the first place? That's what I want to know. Looks like I tried
to... Paimon also gets the impression that we've been here many times, even though we aren't regulars.
Are our casters doing something to us? Is that what's
going
on?
We go again and try something else.
Is that what's going on? Okay. Time to leave. Oh, it's a cozy table, though. I kind of want to stay here. But no, we got things to do. Time to leave the tavern. Okay. Unless otherwise stated, effects that affect sprints would not affect abilities or need alternates, but I still never got that. But yeah, we'll see how long we can hold up. Okay, what is this? Is this another cutscene? It is another cutscene! I knew it! I knew it when it did, like, direct us straight to our normal screen.
Hey! Dinyarzad is sitting by herself on that bench over there!
This is also very familiar.
What a coincidence, Dinyarzad! We meet again! Why are you sitting here all by yourself?
I'm trying to remember what happened.
I ran into some kidnappers just now, but thankfully Dia came to my rescue. I started to feel unwell after that, so I sat down here.
Hey, how many
kidnappers? Oh my goodness, are you hurt?
I'm okay. Dia's arm got scratched, but it isn't serious.
We weren't there this time.
Whew, that's a big relief. But Dinyarzad, you seem a little down today.
And
it's the Sumeru's Festival, and you've been looking forward to it so much!
Not at all. Yeah. I've always been like this. Excessive physical exertion or strong emotions tend to aggravate my illness. Besides, no matter how amazing today may be, it is but a single day. After however many more days, my time will come to an end.
Follow you, and Paimon feels like something's really got you down right now.
I'm so sorry for leaving you behind earlier. Does that mean that Nilu already met up with the academia and was told not to do the dance?
It really is fine. I don't mind.
Here's the number of strange events. Have you noticed anything out of the ordinary?
Huh? Did something happen?
Maybe.
Dinyarzad, have you ever felt deja vu? You know, like when you've already experienced something that's happening right now?
Deja vu? No. But my days have been the same for years now. Even if I were feeling deja vu, I suppose I would already be used to it.
Oh, Paimon sees. Then, is it only the two of us?
It's almost time.
Huh? Time for what?
Oh, the Nilu part.
Nilu's Dance
yet.
Of Sub-Zeros is about to begin. Let's go.
What is going on? This game is really confusing me. Send help. Like, what is the deja vu supposed to be? That's the question. Is it like a plot device, or is it... is it supposed to be some, like, alternate effect of the...
With your lack of intellectual credentials, I do not believe you are qualified to debate with me. What you should be doing is finding workers to tear down this ridiculous eyesore.
I'm so confused.
When we return, have the scribe draft an ordinance before the next Nyagarbaha day that prohibits public art performances. We will publicly announce it later through the Akasha.
Understood. I will inform him when I return.
The Sub-Zero's
festival. Loop and Hari,
go celebrate the birth of that god to your heart's content.
I don't remember that. Oh. I think I vaguely remember, but it's been a while. Man, how would he see Zamiya? What a blast from the past.
Nilu,
back in the days where I would watch anime more regularly.
Oh. Junior Zod, the Grand Sage ordered us to stop the performance.
It's okay. There's nothing we can do about it.
But you've been really looking forward to this. I don't want you to have any regrets.
It truly is unfortunate, but I don't want to cause trouble for anyone. Didn't the Grand Sage say that he might investigate the organizers?
True, but...
same thing? Yeah.
Well, okay. I'll just have to try again next year.
The next festival. I probably won't be around by then.
Wait, what did you just say?
Oh,
nothing. I'll be heading back to rest. Thank you for your help, everyone.
I don't think you
caught
that
before. Paimon can't believe
what
those heartless geezers did!
For some reason, I felt like this outcome was inevitable.
Did Junior Zod already go back?
We broke the fourth
wall. We should also return and get some sleep.
Oh, okay. Are we... right? Okay. It's saying the Sub-Zero's festival was forced to come to an unfortunately abrupt end. And then we sleep, and then... oh, is it Groundhog Day? Is that what's happening? Are we forced to go to the same time?
So, in the end, you still couldn't figure out what that deja vu feeling was all about?
Same things again and again.
Maybe it really was because of exhaustion.
Of the same day, by 6 or 7 to loop, the viewer starts wondering if it's conclusion. Maybe that's why I don't remember so well. Maybe it's because I hated season 2. I don't remember if I hated season 2 or not. I just remember watching season 1, mostly. And even then, that was a while ago. Really goody goggy. I haven't thought about it, but my head does feel very heavy.
Same here. That's why Paimon stopped thinking about it halfway through the day.
That's smart, Paimon. Maybe I should do the same thing you
do. How about we settle in and get a good night's sleep? For now, we can chalk things up to exhaustion. We can do more thinking tomorrow.
Is that my screen just now, or... oh, hey, squirrel! Oh, is that weird cutscene again?
The output of Nyama energy, but values still remain within normal parameters.
Is someone experimenting on us? I knew it.
And find the cause as
soon as possible. Suspicious. We're being experimented on. Are they forcing us to walk through the same time loop? Oh no.
Why does Paimon feel so tired after so much sleep?
Oh no.
Anyway, we should go meet Junior Zod right away.
I did not consent to this experiment. That's not how ethical science works. Oh gosh. Do we have to do this again? Oh no, I don't want to do this again. Oh dear. Oh god, here we go. Here we go. No. I don't don't want to do this anymore.
Good morning, Kinyarzad. Sorry to keep you waiting.
Not at all. I arrived early.
Huh?
Paimon thinks you sound kind of tired. Did you not get enough sleep?
We didn't get enough sleep either. Is she
being affected?
There's
no need to worry. Shall we go? Let's start with the stalls over there.
Someone's experimenting on us.
Let's get going. Traveler?
What a strong sense of deja vu. If we have to go through, if we have to walk with her again, I swear. I'll just skip this whole cutscene anyway.
It's all thanks to Miss Dunyarzad's sponsorship that the children can enjoy the Sub-Zero's festival.
Okay, good, 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 good.
Oh, are you interested in Yalda candies? I have some boxes of candy here. Pick whichever one you want.
Not much of a choice. All these boxes look the same.
It's not that simple. Each box contains a random flavor. It's up to the luck of the draw. Flavors include lavender melon, Hara fruit, sunsetia.
That's good.
They all sound pretty tasty.
And there's also lizard tail and oni kabuto.
What were those last two? She'll help me choose. Paimon wants to eat the sunsetia flavor.
Paimon,
no
don't
problem.
You notice I'm still
These
pretty
These boxes
grouchy.
Of candy are numbered 1 to 5 from left to right. Which one do you want?
Oh, this is too funny. Even the game is going meta. It's on number 4!
Oh-ho! I like your confidence. No hesitation at all. Oh, congratulations! Number 4 is indeed Sunsetia.
Or else.
Paimon knew she always had incredible luck!
We're going through different experimentations. One is lizard tail.
Paimon's not really interested in the other flavors.
Wait. How did you know? Don't tell me that you already knew which flavor was in each box.
What?
She was right about
I know
all
everything.
Of them?
I'm the traveler.
That couldn't have been luck. How is this possible? I packed all those boxes this morning and they've been sealed ever since. You couldn't have known beforehand.
Because I am special.
Mind reading?
I try
X-ray vision? Or some kind of magic trick? This is way too freaky.
This is very freaky.
Tell us what's going on! Since when did you get superpowers? Traveler?
Oh. That explains everything.
Hey, where are you going? What's going on? Did you see something?
Following Nahida?
Us leaving Dunyarzad without letting her know is kind of rude, you know.
Oh, wow. I can see from that far away. Speaking of which, I need to go to the optometrist. It's been a while. Of course, there's only one pathway to go from here. The moment I've been waiting for. Let's go. what? Is that a bird in a cage?
What are you looking for? Why did we come here? Traveler?
What? This squid just blinked? As if, like, we were in... As if it was, like, a broken movie?
Oh. That's...
Wait, Paimon, you're seeing what we're seeing, too? Oh, the bird disappeared! What? Are you here? Oh. Hello? Are you there? Do you see us?
She has pointy...
Wait, Nahida has pointy ears? I never realized that. Oh, the cute outfit! Oh, gosh. That's so cool. Oh, what?
Look, that's... Isn't that Junior-san?
This reminds me of a horror movie. Like some weird things happening and then boom, things move. I feel like we're watching a horror movie.
What's happening here? Why are there two Dinyarzads?
You already know that this isn't your first Sub-Zero's festival, don't you?
Alert.
I'm sure you already know how to use this.
A knowledge capsule? Where did you get it? What's inside?
Guess we'll see, Paimon.
You should use it too, Paimon.
You know Paimon?
Let's use it together, Paimon.
Well, this seems kind of sketchy, but Paimon feels like this is what we should do.
Then I'll explain. We'll be able to... Maybe we'll finally be able to figure out why we're having a weird deja vu. Whoa!
What the?
So many days more for memories? Has someone been storing our memories?
This is our 20th time at the Sub-Zero's festival? Huh? No. The 30th? 40th? Just how many times have we been to the Sub-Zero's festival?
Too many times.
In a single day? If it weren't for you, we wouldn't have even realized.
Oh my gosh!
What the heck was inside that knowledge capsule?
I haven't seen Nahida's eyes up close.
Your memories are still scrambled? Try your best to remember. This isn't the first time we've met, and I answered that question a long time ago.
Let Paimon think. Oh, it's coming back. Meeting you was the real catalyst for restoring our memories, and the knowledge capsule was just your means of showing our minds the way.
Wait, did we even play?
What about everyone else?
I'm doubting myself.
Why are you only helping the two of us?
Your sense of deja vu is stronger than everyone else's, yes? As for an explanation, you two received the blessing of Dendro.
Oh no.
And you also have special, sensitive constitutions. It was as if a single sheet of paper was separating those memories from your consciousness.
What?
A familiar question. I think this is the 7th time you asked that. As you can see, she isn't doing well. You probably sensed it too. The Dunyarzad you were just with is different from the first Dunyarzad you met. That first Dunyarzad is in front of you right now, and she doesn't have a lot of time left.
What I need to do right now is break out of this cycle. How do we break the time loop?
Looks like you're almost done sorting out your brain. Oh yeah, I'm Nahida.
We officially meet Nahida. I know, you introduced yourself before.
Good. You passed the test.
What's happening? You could awaken our memories, and you seem like you know what's going on. Oh, wait. Please don't tell Paimon, even you don't know.
Everything in this world runs in a loop. This cycle is called a samsara. You, me, and everyone else are all stuck inside a one-day samsara.
What?
As for the truth, that's on you to find out. If you were told the truth instead of discovering it yourselves, it would literally blow your minds. I don't know how you'd be after that. I can only give you surface-level help, like bits of information and subtle hints. For the rest of the time, I'll be doing all I can to slow down Dunyarzad's illness.
Are you Lesser Lord Kusanali?
She looks like she isn't doing well at all. Her illness gets worse after each Sub-Zero's festival.
Yes, you are Lesser Lord Kusanali, right? I knew that from the very beginning. Not
if we can break out of the samsara, I might be able to save her.
Out of game context already.
But as things are right now, she's just a small bird in the sky that's about to lose its last feathers. All I can do is raise a gale to delay her fall.
You sure love to use weird analogies.
Analogies are wonderful tools. They let you use existing knowledge to understand unfamiliar things. Okay, so, with what you know so far, what do you think the truth is?
Let me collect my thoughts. Yes, that's the truth. This is a game. When you enter a state of contemplation, you can choose any text entry to interpret it. This interpretation process involves analysis of the text entry. Okay. Text entry. It may yield new entries. Once interpreted, you may submit that text as a conclusion. Oh, what is this? Some text entries can be associated with one letter once interpreted. Select associate to choose the other text entry. This select trigger association. You can gain new text entries by performing accurate associations. We're doing this now at this time of night. If one of the text entries on the current page can be used as conclusion, then select that entry before choosing submit conclusion.
We've already experienced the Sub-Zero's festival many times, and the day of the festival seems to be in a perpetual samsara.
Is this Lumina's voice? I haven't heard her voice in forever.
The moon, illusions, and lies. What do they all mean?
Nahida thinks like a philosopher. She is really deep, that's true.
What's happening right now seems to have happened before. This feeling has been getting stronger and stronger. The Grand Sage said, go celebrate the birth of that god to your heart's content. Did he mean something more? My mind feels exhausted, even though I haven't done too much thinking. What is going on?
Okay. Let's see.
I can't seem to cohesively piece everything together.
Just redo a process of elimination. You think deja vu, Pete? Whoa, time loop.
That should be it. The flow of time is endlessly cycling within one single day.
Oh, is that it? This is it?
That doesn't sound right. I need to carefully think things through.
Oh, we had to pick the right one, okay.
A time loop.
Of course, we're missing it all.
You've given similarly wrong answers in the past. A pity. Still the wrong
answer? That's
so
obvious from the beginning.
I haven't thought that made a lot of sense.
I've seen, what,
it feels
Looper,
like time's just repeating itself. A simple time loop can't explain some of the phenomena.
How many
you two are still missing a lot of information. Unfortunately, I can't give you any more hints.
Yeah, apparently that's Lumina's voice. It couldn't have been Paimon or Nahida otherwise. But yeah, it's
the
very rare.
The Sub-Zero's festival is happening every day, but that doesn't mean we can waste an
very
infinite amount of them. Hurry and
it's
find the truth before today's festival ends.
Oh, what do we have to do before today's festival ends? Oh, this cutscene.
Let's think about our current situation. To save Dunyarzad, we have to escape the samsara of the Sub-Zero's festival. And to do that, we need to figure out what's happening. The truth.
Nahida
rejected the idea of a time loop, so we must have missed something,
Wait,
right?
Wait, it's not a time loop?
Paimon's memories say that we've already done this many times, but let's go talk to people again. It's more productive than sitting here and scratching our heads. Why don't we start with those stall owners?
Okay. Whoa, this is too much for my brain. If it's not a time loop, what is it? But anyways, that's where I'm gonna end stream, because it is pretty late. Thank you everyone for tuning in. Thank you to Pete and Alex for the resubs, and thank you to all who were lurking. Oh, it's a wild adventure. Sumeru's story is finally getting to an interesting part. So, yeah.